Langkawi. I will remember this UNESCO listed mysterious archipelago for her golden hours, mysterious clouds and incredible hospitality. I want to go back to Langkawi to have fun at the duty-free island and take up new adventures at the Skybridge. We stayed at the resort World Langkawi. It's a beautiful property at the edge of the island, away from bustle of Pantai Cenang, which is sort of the heart of Langkawi. Apart from grand architecture, Resort World Langkawi had an amazing infinity pool and beautiful rooms with view. It was hard to leave the pool and go sightseeing in Langkawi, and you will see it for yourself when I'll show you the pool.
So I stayed up the whole night to click this beautiful, beautiful sunrise, and it's totally worth it. But I just want to show you the sunrise that's happening. It's amazing. And of course I'm shooting it. It's happening there. Amazing, amazing sunrise. Ready and set to go to this place called Langkawi Skywalk, and this is supposed to be one of the largest skywalk of the world, and it's very, very scenic. So yeah, and it's 4 o'clock, so we are hoping to catch the sunset. It's actually 5, so excited. This is the hotel where I'm staying in.
একটা ছোট জলপ্রপাত আছে দেখেছিস কি
You can also take the sky glide, which is sort of a train, but instead we chose to walk down the ancient rainforest, and of course it was very, very beautiful, and the walk was indeed rewarding. Finally, when we reached the sky bridge, it was truly breathtaking.
Finally, on the top. There was zero visibility, no point of coming here during sunset, which is what we thought or we planned in the beginning. Oh my god, okay.
Ideally, for a clear view, you should reach the Langkawi Sky Cab early morning. You should be getting a favorable weather condition to get a clear and far-stretched view. However, when we reached, it was cloudy and covered in mist, but we got lucky and we could at least see a very, very beautiful sunset. Looking at the clouds, we almost thought we'll not get any view, but we got lucky and we could at least see a golden sunset on the sea. On a clear day, from the top of the bridge and even on the further height, you will be rewarded with a stunning view of the sky, the sunset, the mountains, that too from a height. It really, really looks amazing. Nonetheless, the day we visited, it was windy and misty and covered with clouds, and I loved what I saw. And if you want a clear view, try to visit the Sky Bridge first thing in the morning. After we explored the Sky Bridge, we took the Sky Glide, which is basically like a train ride, and reached the top level. This also looked like one of the highest viewpoint of the island. And we had to run fast because they had rang the bell and it was time they were closing down for the day. The place that you see here is also known as Datai Bay. It's one of the finest places to stay in Langkawi. A lot of luxury resorts are here.
Look at the seaweed!
There are 7 different night markets in Langkawi for 7 different days of the week. The one we went was the closest one to the Sky Bridge. As usual, the Langkawi night market is a great way to observe local life and how different cultures of Southeast Asia and South Asia, that is India, has actually blended well. For example, I found basmati rice being sold here. Apart from that, it is also a great place to try local cuisine. Though this is not Penang, Langkawi cuisine is heavily dependent on local produce. There were plenty of fish. Also chicken and beef, because Langkawi is a Muslim majority society, they do not sell pork very often. You also get to see a lot of live pets being sold. There were ducklings, there were chicks. One thing about Langkawi night market which I found worrisome was they use plenty of plastics, you know, single-use plastics, and they really do not have a way to recycle it, which is troublesome in the long run.
I give you extra. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, welcome. Where you come from?
India.
Yeah. Which hotel are you staying?
Calcutta.
Resort World.
Oh, Resort World, yeah.
Is that called?
Resort World. Chicken and pao. Wow, it's a good thing.
One place we saw them making Maggi, and not instant noodles of local produce, but Maggi. And they were cooking that with soy sauce and serving with salad. Needless to say, the mango shake was the winner of the night.
Have you ever taken a look at it? That's why I'm eating the cucumber. That got me shark.
Bolli kono bolli
নিয়ে ওটা আমার ফুলটা নিয়ে
নিয়ে
actually the longest stretch of the beach, and it's sunset time, and it's a sunset. So you can also go for different kinds of water sports, so there are paragliding and water taxi and stuff like that. You can do if you want.
The most happening place in the entire island of Langkawi is the walking street of Pantai Cenang. While Langkawi is a sleepy and peaceful island, unlike other islands of Southeast Asia, say Phuket or, you know, places like that from Thailand, which are known as party places, Langkawi is more ideal or more suited for family travelers, romantic honeymoon and stuff like that. However, Pantai Cenang is the only exception to that list. It is at Pantai Cenang you can shop your heart out, you can shop cheap, and by the street side there were street food stalls, food truck, along with really nice restaurants. 3 days we stayed at Langkawi, every day we had dinner from Pantai Cenang, though we were not staying close by. And you actually find Chinese, Indian, Turkish, Arabic, even Bangladeshi, which is Bangali also. On the last day in Langkawi, we decided to go for an island hopping tour. We booked a half a day tour with a local tour agency that took us on a boat. The ferry was close to our hotel, which is Resort World Langkawi. They promised to take us to 4 different points, and first of which was the pregnant maiden lake. You have probably seen this picture from the top. It looks like a woman, a sleeping woman with a protruding belly, which is why it's called the pregnant maiden lake. It is here where you can actually swim in fresh water. It's a freshwater lake surrounded by mountains and the sea, which is also a marvel of the nature. And it is a beautiful scenic place. However, visiting here is a challenge because there are lots of monkeys on the road, and monkey bite is not what you want on a holiday. From there, they took us to a place where they were feeding the eagles, which was just blah. And next up, we visited Pulau Bashar Island. It is one of those idyllic, typical tropical island with golden sand, not golden, white sands actually, and clear water. And you can actually stay here as long as you want. It's the best place hands down that I have been in Langkawi. This and Skybridge. I am actually conflicted in my mind which one wins, but I loved Pulau Bashar, no question asked. So Langkawi archipelago, which actually has 99 or more small islets and big ones also. Big ones are inhabited, small ones are not. This is one of the small islets. And during high tide, the sea comes up, but we visited during low tide and we could actually walk up to the middle of the sea and it was really nice.
Ankita washing Rupok's pant in Andaman Sea. Ankita is a very good wife. Ankita does everything that Rupok tells her to do.
So that's it guys, that was our stay in Langkawi. Do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. If you do that, I would be inspired to make more videos, and I will see you soon with another travel video next week. Till then, stay safe.